Daman, one of the first questions that I would like to ask you is, you know, after having researched and written this book, what, according to you, was the most significant reform movement in mental health care in pre-independent India?
From what I gathered from my research, the whole reform movement really started in the year 1900. And I think the most significant thing was that the then government, the British government, realized that mental health required specialists. It didn't require just sort of general practitioners. It required doctors who were trained in what was then called psychological medicine. And also it required people who were committed to a career in psychological medicine. So not a doctor who came and worked in a mental hospital for 2 years and then was transferred to some completely different area and completely different subject. So I think this was a very significant move by the British government in India.
In your book, you mention a wide range of therapies given to people with mental health conditions in the early 20th century. Anything that struck you as peculiar in the treatments that were given?
Not peculiar, but what struck me as surprising was that how very basic these therapies were and how very valid they are even today. I'm not talking about, you know, strictly medical therapies, but things like proper nutrition, adequate rest, recreation. I think the early psychologists and psychiatrists gave a lot of emphasis on recreation, on keeping busy, on, you know, being engaged in productive activities, on entertainment. So these were things that were considered important then, particularly in the 20s and 30s. And I think they're equally important today, but we have sort of more or less forgotten them.
Mental health, as you point out, was not on top of India's priority for the longest time. When did things start changing? And I'm talking post-independence, at least the first 20, 30 years. When did, you know, the conversation start picking up?
No, I think the story of mental health care in post-independent India is quite a disheartening one. You know, it was like two steps forward, one step back. I would say that for the first several decades, very little progress was made. I mean, sure, they sort of tinkered with the system and made a few improvements here and a few improvements there. But the kind of reform that was needed was just not happening. And I think it was only in the 80s and the 90s that a combination of actors, a combination of players, principally, that is the press or the courts. But that was when the late 70s, early 80s, when PIL had just been introduced. And very, very interesting cases were filed by pioneering people. And I think this is when things really started to move.
Of late, there's been a lot of conversation around mental health, especially in the last decade. But do you think we are doing enough?
No, we are not doing enough. I mean, if you go by a survey that was a national level survey that was done, which was published in 2015, it said that there were about 150 million people who needed treatment. And only one in five actually got treatment. Simple statistic, we are clearly not doing enough. And apart from statistics, I mean, if you look around, you know, people you know, people you don't know, there is still so much ignorance, so much prejudice, so much stigma, so much shame that is attached to this particular condition.
Subscribe to Midday India. Get direct notifications on all our videos by clicking on the bell icon.